Green is in a very musical mood today. But the other bunnies aren't really enjoying it. Oh, where's that great music coming from? The bunnies are so curious. Hello, dust bunnies. Are you all having a fun time? Sounds like someone's at the door. Oh no! The music's been turned off! Aw, don't be sad. We should be able to resume the music. But hold on. Do you know how to do it? To the computer, little ones! All right, dust bunnies. Let's resume the music again using the computer. Now, dust bunnies, that's not how we get the music back on. To use a computer properly, we need to know about the different hardware devices that make up a computer. Just as our faces show the world what we're feeling, this device shows us what the computer is working on. It's called a monitor, and it's like the face of a computer. It can show us images, text, icons, and even videos. That's not it. It's also used to read books, play games, view pictures, and a lot more. Awesome! Now, let's look at another hardware device. The keyboard. It helps us give inputs to the computer. It has a lot of buttons or keys, and we use them to give information to computers. Did you know that most keyboards have over 100 keys on them? That's right, we have so many keys for different purposes. There are keys for letters, numbers, special characters, and even some special functions. Pressing these keys lets us type out words, numbers, and even play games. Now, this device is called a mouse. It does look like one too, right? By the way, how do you point at someone? You're right, with your index finger. Similarly, the pointer or cursor of the mouse is used to point and select things on the monitor. We can control a mouse with our hands. Just slide it around on a flat surface and the cursor will move in the same direction too. Hey, look, that's a really cute photo of a puppy. But how do we get this photo on paper? Well, that's what a printer is used for. A printer helps us get text or images from a computer onto paper. Awesome! We now have a printout of the image. And lastly, we have speakers that let us enjoy music. Just as our mouths allow us to speak, speakers allow computers to play music and other audio files. Yes, computers can be a lot of fun. But what about the music? Try pressing the space bar to get the music back on. Yay! That's how it's done, little ones. Awesome work! Green sure had a lot of fun learning about the hardware of a computer. Do you think you can name all the parts of your computer?